My aunt is a retired middle school science teacher. She loves all aspects of the subject: botany, geology, archaeology. During her time as a teacher, she would take workshops during the summers. One in particular was in New Mexico, so off she went with a group of fellow teachers. One night after an exhausting day of field studies, my aunt and her group were headed back to their hotel near Roswell. It was around midnight, but the hotel was not far from their site. Because of this, they didn't feel like they needed a map. The group passed an old rinky-dink convenience store on the side of a four-way stop. They remembered that earlier in the day, they had passed it on their way to the site. From the four-way stop, they went straight. 10 minutes later, they passed the same store. The group laughed, thinking the sun and their exhaustion had made their memory foggy. Confident, they kept going straight. 10 minutes in, they passed the store again. Worried, the group headed right at the stop. They passed the store again. They took a left, passed it again, and again. Finally, somehow, they made it to their hotel. When I was in high school, my uncle would throw me a couple bucks to help babysit his kids with my aunt. They lived in a two-story house by the water, nice area. The kids were 3 and 6 years old. One day I was sitting in their den on my phone when I started to hear a baby cry. Thinking it was the 3-year-old, I headed to the bottom of the stairs to check to see if my aunt was up there dealing with it. I called for her a couple times, but there was no response. The baby kept crying. I called for my aunt one more time. When I got no response, I started walking up the stairs. I then heard my aunt and cousins playing outside. All the hairs on my body stood up. I quietly turned around, walked down the stairs, got in my car, and drove away. The baby, or whatever it was still crying when I closed the door behind me. A few years later, I was drunk at a family party, and I told my uncle the story. He told me that he and his wife used to hear the baby too. Apparently, the previous owners had a kid die of sudden infant death syndrome in that room upstairs. My uncle is a Catholic and had a mass said for the baby. He said after that happened, never heard the baby again. Still gives me the chills when I talk about it, though. My brother was helping me move across the country. We borrowed a van and loaded everything up for the trip. Just before we left, I checked my watch and called my girlfriend. I told her we'd be hitting the road soon. We set out, but we couldn't do more than 80 miles an hour because of the load. When we took the off-ramp to my new city, my brother told me he couldn't remember the trip. When I thought about it, neither could I. We both thought we were tired and thought nothing of it. However, when we arrived at my new house, my girlfriend asked if I broke the speed limit because we were there almost an hour early. My brother and I retraced our route. We both agreed that we could remember passing a certain gas station, but nothing after that. To this day, we have no clue what happened during that time we missed, or how we could have traveled that fast. Not with any car or van, at least. I have this pair of earrings with a series of distinct black glass beads. Not long after I bought them, I was sitting at my old desk, fiddling with one of them in my hand. A bead slipped off the brass wire. I heard it fall on the hardwood floor and bounce a few times. I immediately searched for it, but couldn't find it anywhere after nearly 1 hour of searching. The earrings were a little uneven after that, which annoyed me, but I kept them. A few years later, I was living in a different city. I dropped another piece of jewelry on the floor while sitting at a completely different desk in my home office. When I bent down to find the piece of jewelry, the first thing I came across was the missing bead from before. I was in complete disbelief when I picked it up. I found that it slipped perfectly back onto the brass wire, balancing out the number of beads. I have nothing else like it in terms of jewelry. I even vacuumed earlier that same day with a new vacuum. I have no logical explanation for this, and I've searched long and hard for one.